Before we start the video, guys, you can get your first month of Envato Elements for only $9 via the link below. If you've watched this channel or if you're a video editor, you probably know what Envato Elements is. It's a pretty good deal. Check it out. Every subscription helps the channel. All right, let's get into this video. And how's it going, guys? Josh Olufemii here, live from LA. And in the last couple of videos, I actually had a couple people ask whether or not this mic was fake. Well, I can assure you that it is a real mic. You can probably hear that it is a real mic now that I'm going away from it. What I actually did in the past few videos is I didn't like how this plastic, I didn't like how it looks in the light. It kind of gives you a weird reflection. There's a lot of scratches in it. So what I did is I went into Photoshop and I actually put like a black solid that I cut out to be the exact same shape of the mic. And I lowered the opacity a little bit to kind of smooth things over. This mic doesn't move, so I didn't need to track it. It just stood still. And unfortunately, it made the mic look fake. And this is how the mic looks. Absolutely no changes done in all of its glory. In this video, I'm gonna tell you guys the importance of theming in music videos. So on the topic of theming, we're gonna be breaking down one of director Sei's newest videos for Rayma, entitled Woman. Director Sei is a crazy talented director. He runs UAX Studios. I am literally glued on their Instagram. They are always posting incredible stuff. And guys, before we move on, please make sure to click the like button down below. And why not, while you're at it, click the subscribe button. And I promise we got some dope content in store for you this month. So moving along, we're talking about music video visual theming and how it's used to add depth to cinematography as well as narrative. Like I've said in past videos, a great theme is usually restrictive enough so that it's distinguishable, but broad enough to allow for a certain amount of visual complexity. Whether it be the vintage dreamy look in Rayma's Ginger Me, or the colorful, contrasty, grainy look in Night's Fireback. Director Sei seems to religiously stick to a specific theme with each of his projects. It's what gives his videos that distinguishable feeling of intentionality and high production value. Going back to Rayma's Woman, you can tell that the theme revolves around the snapping of photos. The video opens up with Rayma surrounded by photos of a woman, stuck on his wall, and hanging up to dry on the line. He starts meeting the woman one by one, then two by two, until the entire set is full of women propositioning him. All throughout the video, you can see the theme of photography bleeding into even the way the video is edited. This is the part that really made me love the video. Check this out right here. You can see this all throughout. You can see different clips freezing on a specific frame and then crossfading onto the next clip. You can even see other places where the freeze frame is actually hidden in between a sudden jump cut. You can also see hard cuts that are doubled up with scaled up semi-transparent footage overlays, almost reminding me of the shutter coming down as a photo is snapped. All throughout the video, video clips transition into each other via a bright flash, simulating, of course, a camera flash. Check out this glorious shot right here. Rayma is on the ground, rocking his body out, and again, the frame freezes right when the background light fixture brightens suddenly. It's such a beautiful and intentionally on theme shot choice. And I even love how Sei decided to crossfade into that movement as not to give up the momentum of the song's pacing in the chorus. An issue that I've actually had with incorporating stills in my edits is momentum being lost. But Director Sei's consistent combining of freeze frames, which are image stills, with immediate crossfades into movement-filled clips basically solves this issue. Like I said in the past video, this is probably one of my favorite music videos of 2020. And guys, check this out. How does this video end? With a completely fresh setup and wardrobe change where different women are posing majestically. For what? A photo, of course. And snap, there's the photo being taken right there. And the video officially ends with Reima just lying down on the ground on his back, being circled around with a bunch of course, Polaroid photos. And he's just reminiscing on his incredible day. So guys, make sure you actually take a look at this video in its entirety. Links down below. Go give director Sei a follow on Instagram, tell him I sent you, and get ready to really be inspired by his other content. Remember, of course, you can sign up for Envato Elements and get your first month for only $9. Pretty good deal. Subscribe to this channel, and as always, remember to keep it chill.